abruptly, but quickly, just across the coast. The airport is 11 degrees, so it's warming up a tiny bit. Taunton's 12, Gympie is 8, and Nambour is 13. So it's time to get out of bed, everybody. But don't leave where the radio is right now, because there's a bit of a big moment happening, a bit of ruckus in the studio. It's EBTOF, which stands for Emma Bridget Tomlinson and her own production, Opera Funk, with composer Sean Peter Ross and Peter Koppes of The Church. Stick around for that. That will be with you shortly, but coming up after them, so stick around for that as well, is Caitlin Mary's Cheap TV and Streaming segment. We're talking about the final quarter and the heart of Dixie. Some new programs out that she's going to be talking about. What have we got on the text here? Some cheeky people. Glenn. Glenn's got a bit of momentum here. As per his earlier tweet, very funny, he's written now, "Hi John, and I'll try to censor this as I go. Hi John, I cannot believe Clive Palmer is still smirking at us from his billboards at Yarrumba. It's true. It's like he's rubbing Coulomb's nose in it. I'm sure they pose a traffic hazard as people drive by and laugh uncontrollably or vomit in their lap." Goodness gracious, Glenn, you're on a roll. I like it. That's nice. Very nice. Maybe we should give the area a quick makeover, like build another giant hotel there. How about that? Glenn didn't say that last bit, but I did. And I'm not condoning it. I'm just trying to make a joke of the situation, of course. Hey, a quick little word from our new sponsor.
Are you sick of stubbing your big toe? Sick of belligerent bunions and arthritis? Then get a rubber toe. From plastic surgeon to the stars, Dr. Harry Hordensack. Dr. Hordensack uses a patented procedure to remove your burdensome digit and replace it with a durable and attractive stub. Patient Mal Meninga.
Oh, I kicked thousands of goals with my rubber toe. I also used it to intimidate the opposition by painlessly kicking large boulders and confidently walking in dog poo.
Swap your troublesome stump for a pliable prosthetic. Get a rubber big toe from plastic surgeon Dr. Harry Hordensack today.
Great work, Dr. Harry Hordensack. Thank you very much. Now, in the studio, composer Sean Peter Ross, Peter Koppes from The Church, and Emma Bridget Tomlinson. Good morning, everybody.
Good morning.
Good morning.
They're bending over these mics because the mics are bent over some instruments, so there's a lot of odd postures right now, aren't there? Let's start with you, Emma. You were having a bit of a laugh then. What's going on?
I was. Well, this morning, it's actually ironic with that commercial. I actually stubbed my toe really bad to the point where there was a lot of blood.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
You could get it replaced with a rubber toe.
Exactly.
Yes.
I think I need to.
Tell us a little bit about Opera Funk. What's going on? What is it?
All right. So Opera Funk is a show that my mum and I came up with, and it basically is out of the ordinary. So Opera Funk isn't just with classical music. It has a lot of musical theatre as well as jazz compositions and some compositions that were written by Pete and from his band The Church, as well as some of my own stuff as well.
So but you're traditionally an opera singer, is that right? Or what's your style?
So I do sing opera, but I'm actually a classical crossover with pop.
A slashy.
Yeah, I'm a slashy.
Right.
That's right.
Okay.
Slashy.
But you've just been in Europe doing singing?
No.
No, but last time I saw you, weren't you over there or something?
No. I wish.
I wish. Okay. Here, I'm confused.
Is there another me over there?
Maybe there is. All right. And so this is all part of the Noosa Alive. Are you going to take it anywhere else?
Yes, of course. Well, this is the fourth show that I've done. So the fourth encore, as I started in the little Coran Hall in my hometown. And then I moved on to the Karoi Arts Hall and then went on to Foxy and Coulomb. And now I made it into Noosa Alive and possibly, hopefully, one day could get to QPAC.
Yeah, wouldn't it be great?
Yeah, that'd be great. Fantastic.
Who are your collaborators here? How do you know Peter Koppes sitting next to you?
Well, when
you went to school together.
Not like that, though.
I was the teacher.
Yeah, right.
Yeah,
right.
So when I moved up to the Sunshine Coast, I was admitted into Noosa District State High School for grade 12, and I was looking at the music program there, and being the only student doing music extension, I thought I need to be able to get some collaboration and get some experience out of it somehow. And when I discovered the studio that they had there, which was the main reason I went to Noosa District State High School, I found that Peter Koppes was a part of it as well, and I started with guitar lessons with him, and then moved on to piano, and he helped me write some of my songs that I'm working on at the moment to get produced with my EP. And yeah, from then on, we've just had a really awesome connection. We understand each other and also understand how music works and the whole thing of songwriting and the poetry of it, and you know, getting the depth of the song as well as like performing it as well.
Ah, I like it. All right. Peter, you might want to just move that mic up a bit so you're not in so much pain. Yeah, there you go. The church is still a very active group. You tour overseas in America quite often. Mm-hmm. How do you have time when do you get time to spend with students?
Well, actually, I broke our drummer's foot so that I could have some time off. Well, actually, he broke it himself, but he fell in a crack in the stage on our last show in America that I fell in before the second set, and he fell in it at the end of the night, but he broke his foot and I didn't. So, in effect, you know, I gave him a warning.
Right.
We've had to cancel all the shows this year.
You're playing live gigs and you're seeing audiences react to what you're mm-hmm. playing. Mm-hmm. How can you pass that on to students? What do you tell them about that?
Well, I do prefer to teach as a mentor and with a songwriting end result. And I use their instrument for that purpose, that they will be songwriters and creative. And it's pretty much a conversation. Like when musicians are together, they have a conversation with their instruments. And that's how music's created. And when you bring that to the stage, there's a kind of a subconscious communication, and communion is probably the word for it.
Yeah,
and
right.
And I say to people, when you get on stage, just trust that there's energy there with everything.
Yeah,
and
right.
If you're not nervous and contagious, that won't interfere with it. That's all my right. best thing to offer.
Best bit of advice. Sean, Sean Peter Ross, I'm going to get you to do a bit of a plug of yourself so we can meet you and know you. What do you do and who are you?
I'm a classically trained musician. I work actually as an English teacher and a freelance musician.
And where are you based?
I'm based in Brisbane.
Okay. Yeah.
Originally from Melbourne, yeah. So I wrote an opera on the life of Tchaikovsky some years ago and have been workshopping it in recent years. So just recently we've signed a contract with the Melbourne Recital Centre to have Act 3 performed in concert.
Wow.
Next year, that's in May, so... yeah, that's exciting.
How did you get on board here? What was the...
I met Emma about 7 or 8 years ago. One of my friends was a good friend of her mum, and that's how we met. And mm-hmm. I gave her a few early singing lessons very early on.
Right.
Way back then.
And so you're a singer yourself?
Yes, I majored in singing at the University of Melbourne.
Okay,
yeah.
Right.
Yeah, so. And from then on, he's pretty much been like my adopted uncle.
Oh,
physical
great.
Uncle,
yeah. Right.
And he actually helped me with some of my singing competitions, which I did when I was 11 and 12. Mm. And he accompanied me in those doing Jar of Hearts and Someone Like You, which is on YouTube as well, and actually got me into the finals of one of my primary school competitions. Mm. But yeah, no, Sean's always been on the way with me, supporting me all through my music. And, you know, we started collaborating with Opera Funk last year and it's just been a hit.
Mm. All right. Now, one of the songs that you're playing at Opera Funk is Under the Milky Way by the Church.
Mm-hmm.
But today we're going to do another one. What have we got here?
We have Love of My Life by Queen.
Why did you choose this song?
Well, I recently this year got out of a relationship that was pretty poisoning to me as well as the people around me. And I felt that having this song, realising that Love of My Life isn't someone that I look for, it's the people who support me and are around me.
Yeah, okay, all right. And we can channel Freddie Mercury as we do it.
Today, yeah, so. Exactly.
All right, here's Opera Funk with Love of My Life. Are you guys right to have a go?
Yeah, absolutely.
All good. Okay, here we go.
My don't leave me. You've taken my heart, but now desert me. Love of my life, can't you see? Bring it back, bring it back. Don't take it away from me, because you don't know what it means to me. Everything's all by the way. And I grow older, I will be there at your side to remind you that I still love you. I still love you. Back, bring it back, please bring it back home to me, because you don't know what it means to me. Love of my life, oh, oh, yeah.
Wow, beautiful. Emma Bridget Tomlinson, composer Sean Peter Ross and Peter Koppes of the Church. Thank you so much for joining us. Just quickly, when's the gig?
The gig is next Saturday on the 27th of July, and it goes from 4:30 to 6:30 with an interval, and it is at the Noosa Arts Theatre in Noosa.
Noosa Arts Theatre, which is down near the AFL grounds.
Yes, there. And beside Aldi. That's an easy
beside
way to
Aldi, that's yes. How I remember. Okay, all right. Hey guys, thanks for coming in. Sounds like a lot of fun. I was waiting for the big headbanging moment, because you can just feel it coming, can't you? But I'm sure there's going to be some headbanging.
Oh, yeah. there will be some headbanging.
Hey, good. Okay. Guys, thanks for joining us. Coming up after the next song, Kate Lemery will be with us to do our cheap TV and streaming segment. You're with ABC Sunshine Coast. It is 17 minutes to, what have we got? 9.